One look at these lively gibbons and egrets, and anyone familiar with the art scene in Singapore will be able to tell their creator. They were painted by none other than Dr. Chen Wen Hsi. Dr. Chen passed away on the 17th of December last year, at the age of 85. He spent an entire lifetime painting and perfecting his craft. In his long and prolific career, he produced a wide range of Chinese and Western paintings. While his forte laid in painting gibbons and egrets, he was also active in merging Chinese with Western art. He brought a new lease of life into Chinese art by absorbing the best of the Western traditions. For more than 40 years, Dr. Chen gave his best both as art teacher and painter. His was a lifetime of contribution to art. In August this year, the government conferred on Dr. Chen the Meritorious Service Award. This was received by his second son, Dr. Chen Xiaoming, earlier this month. It's the first time the government had honored an artist posthumously. Chen Wen Hsi was born in 1906 in China, in a village in the county of Jieyang. His father died when he was 12, and little Wen Hsi was brought up by his uncle. Even then, he had a great love for nature. He once wrote,
"There were many farms in my village. Magpies and sparrows were a common sight. I was captivated by the sounds they made, the way they rushed for food, and their elegant movements as they soared through the air. They seemed to be in their own world, oblivious to everything, and yet alert and resourceful. They soon became my best friends." "I also enjoyed rearing hens, ducks, and geese as a child. My love for small animals came naturally."
The young Chen Wen Hsi also developed an interest in folk craft.
"I love to watch craftsmen paint eaves and pillars. I would strain my neck just to get a closer look. I was deeply moved."
He even tried to paint like the craftsmen he had seen.
"I didn't know much about coloring materials. I simply pounded stones into red powder, squeezed some juices from leaves, and then painted on paper, just for fun."
Because of his love for art and nature, Chen went to Shanghai to pursue an art course after high school. In order to complete it earlier, he devoted all his time and energy to his studies.
"I painted day and night. I never wandered far from the university campus. I didn't even visit the famous Wuzongkou. I had no idea how big Shanghai was, even after graduation."
Chen Wen Hsi's hard work in Shanghai paid off. After graduating from New China University, he returned to Jieyang to be an art teacher. He also held several successful art exhibitions in Shantou, Shanghai, Guangzhou, and Hong Kong. After seeing his works, Xu Beihong, a renowned artist in China, paid him a compliment.
"What you have accomplished is beyond comparison in China."
These words became a source of inspiration for Chen, encouraging him to strive for even greater heights in his work.
"It's not really his at the time knowledge in China, but Xu Beihong is encouraging in such a way that he's later filled with a lot of confidence that he can do it."
In 1947, 41-year-old Chen came to Nanyang to exhibit his works and to gain greater exposure to new art forms. He came to Singapore by land through Indochina. Along the way, he came into contact with many Western paintings and was able to incorporate what he'd learned into his own work. Because of the generosity of his friends in Singapore, he decided to prolong his stay here. But this turned out to be a permanent move. He started off teaching art in Chinese high school. In 1952, he went to Bali with fellow artists Liu Kang, Zhong Shibing, and Chen Zhongwei. There, he produced the renowned Balinese paintings with a distinct Southeast Asian flavor. He also experimented with various techniques and art forms. In 1960, his finger paintings were highlighted in a news filmlet.
Slender branches support birds or monkeys.
In an effort to encourage budding artists, Chen also conducted special art classes for students with potential.
But Mr. Chen is a versatile artist and is equally at home with any materials.
He had painting lessons, extra ones, in the afternoon, free of charge, in the school premises, especially for the selected students. He loves students with talent. And there are occasions when there are students who are so poor that they cannot afford to stay in school because they can't even afford to pay school fee. He will go to the parent and offer them, say, I paid for the school fee for your children. Please let them come to school. Sometimes students cannot buy material. He will buy and give it to them, say, come to the afternoon class, the special class, which he conducts at the school for special talented people.
做人方面他是很慷慨的。 好几次，我知道他从中国来的或者本地的年轻画家开展览会啊，他都去买画，买那些年轻人的画，他这个就是带了一种鼓励、提拔的一种作用。我那次开这个回顾展，他也买我一张画，画家买画，画家的画。
Though generous and gracious towards others, Chen Wen Hsi demanded high standards from himself. To improve his art, he kept many small animals like sparrows, birds, gibbons, and squirrels at home so that he could observe them daily.
要画一件东西，一定要常接触、常观察，很仔细的去。 观察他们的这个生活动态，他这个天天看，看得熟了，那么有的已经把它吸收到脑子里头去。等到这个已经熟悉了，你不必再看，他这个脑子里头已经能够指挥这个手，就把它表现出来。所以你看他的这个猿猴啊，松鼠啊，诸如此类的东西。 他画家是很生动、很活泼，并且有很多种的这个动态，不像有的画家，他画来画去那几个姿势，没有什么变化的，并且看起来是好像很做作，好像特地摆在那边的这样子。他的画呢，就是因为有了这个写生的这个基础了，有那种能力了，所以他画西画很顺畅，画中国画。
也非常流利，但是他又有一个很重要的观点，就是艺术不等于自然。艺术要等于自然，它就不是艺术了。我们通常有一种说法说“栩栩如生”啊，这个说法是不恰当的。我不说这个观点多么错，起码是不恰当的，因为艺术是各种各样的。陈先生明确地表示呢，他说我从自然里边获取了艺术创作的原料之后呢，我要怎样通过高级的艺术手段、艺术技巧，把它加工、分割、把它布置、构图。 通过我的艺术语言、艺术技巧，把它更高的把它表现出来。它的造型非常有意思，它画的猿猴像小孩子一样，非常的可爱，就像一个小孩搭到树枝上荡来荡去的，像荡秋千一样，非常的自如。我想他画猿猴的时候，一定想到是我心目中的猿猴，既是自然中的，又是我心目中的，笔法是不同的。
Chen Wen Hsi spends most of his time on art and had little interest in social activities.
An artist must be able to endure solitude. When one is famous, there'll be many social activities. Whenever I attended functions, I would try to leave early so that I can return to my creative world.
His good friends are well aware of his devotion to art.
I 一早上四点钟到他画廊，就马上画画，画了几张以后才坐下来。有时候我下午去啊，跟我谈话，谈了一半，兴趣来，他说你坐，我还要画画，所以我看到画我也就走。所以他差不多在对时间了、啊，哇，抓得很紧，有时间就画画。He
believed in painting, I would say with religious fervor. He believed in painting more than anything else in the world, yes. To him, it is almost a sacred duty to paint well.
他早上从家里走路到这个画廊，然后一整天都不离开画廊，这个一整天一直在作画。那么每一整年都是这样，也不离开这个画廊。那么一天到晚就是一直在画。那这种敬业精神。
Behind the successful Chen Wen Hsi was a supportive wife who managed his home well.
The lives of many artists are sad stories. I'm more fortunate. My success is due to a happy marriage. My wife has been very understanding. Although I married her, my true love is art.
It wasn't just painting, but spending time with his art books.
Besides Chinese books, English, German, Swedish, these are Dutch, French, even Japanese. But he knows nothing of those languages. Actually, he's not reading the book, he's seeing the book, in the sense that he only look at the pictures. In other words, his language is purely art, a language of art. Sometimes when he just barely browse through, very fast, and when he come across some picture, some painting, which he feel inspired, or that he feels that there is something he can learn from there, then he can stay on the same page, on the same book for hours and days.
I sometimes think it's an advantage not to be able to read what it says, but just look at the picture. Because I feel there is a lot of hot air in commentaries on art. What matters, you see, a lot of people make this mistake. They think they could understand art with the ears. Well, you can't. It's not what you hear, it's what you see.
Chen Wen Hsi's art cuts across national boundaries. He was equally enthusiastic and curious about Western art. He was able to extract the best elements from East and West.
中国画的这个方法呢，我们要保存一方面，我们要吸收这个西洋人的一些说这个技巧。那两种能够融合下来了，我们感觉这个中国画会更特别的这个好了。过去表现的方法呢，它是只注意这个画面方面。 这眼睛的方法，好像光线我们是没有的。现在呢，我们有时候感觉呢，中国画呢是有特长，但是也有短处啊。我们呢表现了这个颜色方面太过简单，壁画方面在西洋画方面有时候是。
很注意这个龙胆光线，但是在中国画方面呢，是注意笔墨呢正面画下去，构图也是一个最大的这个方法。好像中国画常常是图景太过大，啊，那这个西洋画呢，它现在慢慢缩小，它变成它主页这个美呢，并不是大。
它是小部分，它的特色呢，就是讲它因为也吸收了外来的东西，在传统文化里面发展了，发展了，发展它有它的个性，有它的风格，不是跟那个古老的传统文化一模一样。它的一生好像是一个现代美术史的缩影，从具象绘画一直到抽象绘画，一个很宽的领域。 中间有表现主义，有立体主义，也有就是，像一种野兽派的一些东西。作为一个八九十岁的老人，他的思想我觉得是永远是年轻的，这一点非常可贵，始终有一种新的追求，不停留在原来的地方。在他画面上出现的东西，他就是不断的在变换，一种那个，由于他有一个很开阔的一种心胸。 善于吸收，不聚集一些好的东西，所以我觉得他的画就体现了非常丰富的一种内涵。我认为陈先生的画是中国现代艺术，就是中国画走向现代这一个大的变革时期，是一个代表人物之一。
陈先生的艺术道路呢，有这个时代的共性，但是也有这个时代的个性。 他很明确地主张，要走一条中西化并进的道路，就是要体现出他一种胸怀，就是他要把古今中外的，包括世界的艺术，凡是人类一切优秀的文化成果，都想纳入他自己的胸中，在自己的艺术中有所表现。作为古代的艺术家，没有这样一个条件；那么作为现代的艺术家呢，有了这样一个条件，但是有些艺术家没有认识到这样一个优势，他认识到这样一个时代的特点。
是不是有一个图章怎么写的？说万物过眼，即为我有，就是万物全世界看到以后就是我的。但是我认为陈伟先生就是这种可以说万物过眼即为我有的这种立场。我认为他的创作力是很强。陈伟先生是把中国画带动现代绘画这种境界里边，在民国以来，我所认识的画家里边，我认为他是第一个。
In recognition of his contribution to Singapore art, Dr. Chen Wen Hsi was awarded the Public Service Star in 1964. 11 years later, he was conferred an honorary Doctor of Letters degree by the then University of Singapore. In 1980, the National Museum of History in Taiwan awarded him a gold medal, making him the first Singaporean to receive such an honor. In 1987, Dr. Chen received the ASEAN Cultural and Communication Award. During his lifetime, he held more than 40 art exhibitions all over the world. His works received recognition not only locally, but overseas as well. Recently, some of his art pieces were put up for auction in Hong Kong and Taipei, one of the few Singapore artists whose works have gained the interest of international auction houses. Most importantly, his Western art pieces have also been equally well received. His works have become pieces that art collectors are proud and eager to possess.
我的收藏里面大概是以台湾的收藏家为主，但是唯一的例外就是国外的这个画家里面，那唯一有系统的收藏的就是陈大师。那当然这个是有原因，一个艺术家最重要的他就是有他独特的风格。我想这一点让我就是无论怎么样一定要收藏他这么多的画，就因为有他独特的风格。
我想在将来的绘画史上面，我想是会很重要的。
我想陈先生在中国现代史上一个比较重要的画家，虽然他后来呢，远去南洋，周游世界，但是呢，他的根还在中国，在中国现代史上一定要有他一笔，很重要的一笔。当时我原来呢没有把陈先生列入我的中国画的现代史这一部分去，我看了他的画展之后呢，我说一定要把陈先生写入中国画的现代史。
When animals like gibbons and egrets were no longer allowed to be kept in private residences, Dr. Chen insisted on going out to places like the bird park to sketch, even though he was over 80 years old. His mind was always on painting, even though he was ill in the last 2 years of his life.
In his second last admission to a hospital, the one before the admission where he died,he was about to be discharged, and he said to me, I'm going straight to my gallery and I'm going to paint. But when he arrived at the gallery, he was so tired that he could just sit on his reclining chair, his favorite chair for many years, and he used to have an afternoon nap, you know, after lunch. And he could just sit there and had no strength to paint. But his thought was still on painting.
等到他得病的时候，我有时候都知道他在画廊，我去看他。他好像知道，所以大人之命，他就知道他生命呢就差不多了。常常跟我讲，菜，你有空多来做。
Chen Wen Hsi's devotion to art was total.He painted even in his last days, leaving behind two unfinished pieces of work. But in his paintings, he lives on. A man who successfully merged Chinese and Western painting. A man who was a pioneer artist in modern Chinese art. Chen Wen Hsi, master painter, will always be remembered for his devotion and contribution to art.